You guys are not gonna believe where I'm bringing you today. I'm telling you, the moment I walked in through these doors, I got weak in the knees. I'm bringing you guys today to the biggest stingray breeder in the United States, and my friend Kevin here is gonna give us a tour of his facility.
Just a sec. As soon as we walk in, you guys gotta see this. There's so much to see. But what you're going to see is rays on rays on rays. It's absolutely incredible. I'm gonna let Kevin give us a really generic tour of everything he's got going on here. But stay tuned for a lot of other future videos as well, because we're really gonna break this place down. This is the opportunity of a lifetime. Kevin, thanks for having me.
No problem. Well, you already briefly showed them some of the pups. Here we have our breeders. These are our main breeding tanks. They're all about 1500 gallons a tank. We breed mostly higher end stuff, from black diamonds, pearl rays, P14s, hybrids, albinos, some of the rarer strains like Bosmanis and snow leopards.
They're 1,500 gallons a piece?
Uh-huh, okay.
How many of them are there?
We got one, two, three, four. I have six tanks here, and I've got some bigger acrylic tanks over here. This one is about 2,000 something gallons. That one's about 1,500 gallons. These are our black diamond breeders. We have our hybrids here, P14s. We also have Faulkner Eye.
And then here you got some pups. From the looks of things, a lot of pups. And just like you build a lot of this stuff yourself, right? I see you got the table saw, you got some acrylic.
Yeah.
You do a lot of like little handy do-it-yourself projects here and there, don't you?
When I started with building acrylic tanks. So that's what I was into in the beginning. So a lot of the stuff, a lot of my breeder tanks, my pup tanks, my grow out tanks, I did all the acrylic work myself. And from there, I just expanded. I went into dealing with other tropical fish, and ultimately I came to rays. And once I got to rays, nothing else seemed the same anymore.
That's what happened to me. Yeah, absolutely.
And it just became an addiction.
Yep.
Started with two rays, then it just kept going, searching for the new rays, the hard to get stuff. I never look back.
Yeah, you know? Absolutely.
Yeah.
So you guys can just imagine how I feel right now, having the opportunity to come in and see something like this. And when I first came in here, I thought this was it. All these massive tanks, lots of big breeding-sized rays. But then we went around the corner, what I gave you a glimpse at before with all the pups. Let's take a look at that.
Sure. Come on this way.
Big shout out to Wes.
What's up, guys?
From Uncle Sam's Discus for bringing me here. He knew I'd love it.
Oh, yeah. Got to show Joey the rays. Got to show Joey the rays.
So we came in through this front door. We immediately looked over here. We're going to come back to that in a sec. But he's got another little room in here, too. What's going on in here?
This room, I keep some of my grow outs. As the pups get bigger, I like to isolate them. I select out what I feel are nicer ones that are worth putting more time to growing out into bigger animals. So, yeah, this is some of the stuff right here.
It's amazing. So, you got a few of the smaller tanks up there. What size is this down here?
Excuse me?
What size tank is this?
This tank, it's 8x4x30. I think it's like 700 gallons.
Oh, nice.
Is that right? Yeah.
About that. So we're going to have to come back and take a look at how you filter all these and all the maintenance. But for now, we really just got to get a general tour. Next thing was the pups. This was incredible.
Okay. So these are my pup tanks. These tanks are all individual with their own separate filtration. I like to keep them isolated by the litter as they're born. Sometimes when the litters are too big, I'll split them out. I put an average of 5 to 6 newborns into each tank. And as they get bigger, I'll start spacing them out or moving them out into grow out tanks.
And then we walk, it doesn't end there. We walk around the corner.
This way, we're going around to the other side. This is my other breeding room. Some of my more exotic and rarer stuff. We've got, let's see in here, our albinos. We have albino pearl rays. We have albino bosmani, which I'm very proud of because it's the only one in the world.
And albino or bosmani world.
We were lucky enough to catch it in the wild. So it was very, very fortunate for us.
I can imagine. Okay, so these are all breeding tanks. You got all adults in here, no pups. You do have some smaller bosmani down here though.
Yes, these are medium bosmani. These are all wild imports that we imported on a regular basis now.
So you do breeding and importing?
Primarily breeding. Importing is only when something rare and special comes along that I have to get my hands on, and I'll make that special effort to get it.
Right, right.
Yeah.
So if there's a ray that somebody wants, they can get it from you?
I'm pretty sure they can.
Yeah, yes. Absolutely. How did somebody get rays from you in the first place? Where do we go? What do we do?
I'm most active on Facebook.
Right.
So I have my Facebook page. You can reach me there. You know, I'm always putting posts up of stuff that's going on.
Yeah.
So if you message me through there.
What is your Facebook page?
It is Kevin Stingray Biology.
Right.
So you can just search that and get to my page.
Right. What size is this big tank?
This tank is roughly 2,000 gallons.
You got a couple of them.
Yeah. I just started expanding into this side. I slowly moved out the smaller tanks and putting in bigger breeding tanks because... they just keep coming, the babies, and they just keep growing, so I gotta make space for them.
Absolutely.
Know? And it's so much of a hobby for me that when there's something special, you know, I just have to keep it and grow it and, you know, see how it develops. So it's a lot of excitement and fun for me.
Absolutely. Absolutely. What is, what are some of your biggest rays that you have? I don't think a lot of people realize, like, how big these rays get.
Wow, yes. Well, my biggest one, I would say, is close to 38 inches in diameter.
Yeah.
Length, including the tail, oh my God, it's like 4.5 feet.
Wow. Which one was that? Is that on the other side?
It's on the other side. Yeah, we can go back and I'll show you that. But yeah, they do get pretty big. Given the space and the food, they can get really big. Some of our oldest rays are like 25 years old.
25 years old.
25 yeah, years old.
These guys are a lifetime commitment. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, there's so much more I want to talk about and so much more I want to see, but I think for today we're going to cut it off. And but some things I want to talk about is how this whole place runs, your filtration systems. I want to take a closer look at your breeding, how you manage to do that and some of the steps you take.
Sure, not a
awesome.
Problem.
Well, Kevin, thanks for having me today, man. I absolutely appreciate it. Guys, this was an exclusive tour. He's not open to the public, so I definitely appreciate it, my man, and I know everybody at home watching does as well. Until next time, guys, I hope you enjoyed today's video, but if not, join me next Thursday and I'll have something new for you.